Hi friends, today let us discuss about the problem towers of Hanoi. This problem initially it was introduced by a French mathematician Edward Lucas in the year 1883. First we will see what is the problem. So we will define the problem first. So here, for defining the problem, I am going to use this model to discuss the problem in detail. So what you see here, this model, there are three posts or pillars or pegs. So the first post I call it as A, the second post I call it as B, and third post I call it as C. So there are three posts A, B, C. So A, I'll define it as source, B, axillary, C, it is destination. So there are three posts A, B, C. A is known as source, B is known as axillary, and C is known as destination. Now, initially all these posts are empty now. Now I am going to insert a set of disc in post A, otherwise it is known as a source. So there are N disc. Why I call it as N disc? Though I keep 4 discs here, there is no rule that only 4, it may be 5 or 6 or 10, any number. So that is why I call it as there are N disc. And when you see the disc, all the discs are not of same size. So I say N disc of different size. But also you can witness that the discs are kept in an order. So what is the order actually? Arranged in the order of smallest at the top and largest at the bottom. Now, what is the objective of the problem? The objective of the problem is to move all these N discs from post A to post C. So the objective of the problem is move N disc from post A to post C. So now you see what is the complexity in this problem. So the objective is to move all this disc from post A to post C. The complexity is we have to obey the conditions. What is the condition? Number one, move the disc only from the top. So you can move the disc only from the top, you cannot take it from the in between. And what is next? Only one disc can be moved at a time. That is, we cannot take two discs, three discs at a time. We can move only one disc. And third one, we can place a disc only on a larger disc than it. So you cannot place a disc or a smaller disc than it. So that is a condition. So by following all these conditions, we have to move all these N discs from post A to post C. So now we have defined the problem. Now we'll see what is the solution. So now we assume there is only one disc. So this only one disc is post A, so if n is equal to 1. So So what is the solution now? The easiest solution is you move the disc from posterior to posterior. So the solution is move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. And also you keep a table here, number of disc and minimum number of moves. So if there is only one disc, how many moves are involved? There is only one move. If I assume there are two discs, so I'll keep two discs here. So there are two discs in posterior. So now what are the steps? So now move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. This move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. Next, move the disc 2 from posterior to posterior, that is the largest disc. So move disc 2 from posterior to posterior. Finally, you move the disc 1 from posterior to posterior. So that is move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. So now how many steps are involved for n is equal to 2? So for n is equal to 2, the steps involved are 3. Now we want to find the solution for n is equal to 3. If n is equal to 3, that means you assume there are 3 discs on posterior. So I keep the disc here. So now we can start from any post. So I'll start like this. So I'll take the smallest disc and I'll keep it here. So that is move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. Then move disc 2 from posterior to posterior, because I cannot place it here because that is a smaller disc. So now what is the next step possible? So only you can move the smallest disc from posterior to posterior. But now the ultimate aim is to move this largest disc to posterior to posterior. Now this is not possible. So the method what we have started is not suitable to find the solution in minimum number of steps. So again, I'll go back to the original question. So now what is the solution is move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. So you take the smallest disc and move posterior to posterior. Now what is the next step? Move disc 2 from posterior to posterior. So move the next disc from posterior to posterior. Now what we can do? Move disc 1 from posterior to posterior. So that means move the smallest disc from posterior to posterior. Now what is the strategy followed here is, if there are n disc here, move this n minus 1 disc to axillary, but finally move the largest disc to the source to destination. That is move disc 3 from posterior to posterior. So now the largest disc has gone to right place. Now there are two discs here. Now the solution is move this two discs from axillary to destination using source as temporal. So now what is the solution now? Move disc 1 from post B to post A. So move the smaller disc. Now move disc 2 from post B to post C. So that means you move the disc from post B to post C. Finally, move disc 1 from post A to post C. So now all the 3 discs are moved. Now how many steps are involved? 7. So when there are 3 discs, the number of steps involved are 7. So now from this we can find what will be the number of steps if there are n discs. So if there are one disc, one
2 days, 3 moves. 3 days, 7 moves. Then this can be represented as 2 to the power of n minus 1. There are 2 days means 2 to the power of 2 minus 1, 3. There are 3 days, 2 to the power of n minus 1, 2 to the power of 3, 8 minus 1. So if there are 4 days, so the number of steps, 2 to the power of 4 minus 1, that is 15. So if there are n days, the formula is 2 to the power of n minus 1. So that is the solution. So the final solution is, when there are n disks here, move the n minus 1 to axillary, then move the nth disk from posterior to posterior. Then our next step is, when there are n minus 1 here, move the disk from axillary to destination using source as temporal. Even though this problem was invented by Edward Lucas, actually he was inspired by the Hindus, the legend in a Hindu's temple. He told the priest that there are 64 disks in 3 golden pillars. You have to move this all the 64 pillars from source to destination using the same method by following the conditions. And also he told that when you move the 64th disk, the world will vanish. But actually, by applying this formula, it's 2 to the power of 64 minus 1 is a very huge number. So it will take many years. But if it is, we don't know whether it is true or not. So with this, we'll complete the session. Next session, we'll talk about time complexity and space complexity of the towers of Hanoi.